In one of my lectures, I had talked to you about the emotional intelligence. That is what we should try to imbibe. Emotional intelligence. That means the intelligence that is based on emotions. Unless and until we become emotionally intelligent, our society cannot do. With an emotional intelligence, you care and you enjoy caring. You do everything for others with a great emotional understanding. Not for one child, not for one son, but for everyone you have to be emotionally intelligent. Some children are born like this, but some are to be made like that, that they should be emotionally intelligent. Because if the mother and father are money-oriented, very selfish, they won't allow their child to give anything to others. So such a child will grow into a very funny type of a person. And will never do anything for anybody, not even for his own country. Why should he do it? Everything for selfishness. Then such people indulge into corruption, indulge into all kinds of things which are only selfish in attitude. Now we are talking of collectivity. In collectivity we do for others. We enjoy doing for others. We love giving things to others, not for our yourself, because your children will also become the same kind and they'll only bother about themselves. This emotional intelligence has to be brought in our life, in our pattern that we have. Are we emotionally intelligent or we are just intelligent or emotional? Both things are wrong. If you are just intelligent, you can become a very dry person. You may just have few friends, maybe you may not have, and you will always try to preserve yourself away from the collectivity. And if you are emotional, you will be attached only to one person. Attached to one child, maybe, attached to one person, to someone, even in the society. For no rhyme and reason. Why? Why are you attached to one person? Why are you bothered about one person only? All such people fall into such terrible prey. In the politics we have seen how people try to help their own sons and our daughters and this and that, and we Indians have suffered a lot with this kind of a emotional attachment. So according to ethics, emotional intelligence is the highest quality by which you give to others. You care for others, for everyone, and you become very, very correct. Now exclusiveness is another fashion that's very much there. It's exclusive because you don't want to be one of the multitudes, you want to be exclusive. You should be exclusive in emotional intelligence. Not on other things. That is the best thing you can have. As I agree, I am just a woman and just a mother. But what I have is really the emotional intelligence, ocean of it. And from that I know about everyone. I understand about everyone. And all this work has been done because of that quality in my head. I am not attached to one person or to one style. Whatever you say, I can understand, because I am at a level where I can understand everything that you are doing. To achieve that, you try to develop emotional intelligence. Here the children won't even give a toy to somebody to play. Even the mother is like that, the father is like that, extremely selfish. And we must have our own, you see, everything should be our own. This has to go. This has to go from American, especially because they are the leading nation in this kind of selfishness. What selfishness they have done, I did not count, but you know that. You go and ask the people of Canada, Mexico, Peru, all these, they will tell you. Being selfish, they are not ashamed. Being exploiters, they are not ashamed. Nobody can even tell them, because they think they are very rich people. But all these riches will not give him the joy of life. Joy of life is only in the emotional intelligence. If you don't have that, it becomes very dry. Life becomes very unbearable, horrible. And even the family gets broken up. If there is no emotional intelligence in the family. I have known so many women who have had 3 marriages, 5 marriages, I don't know how they can do it, but they have done. Because this lack of emotional intelligence. It is something that is a sense of giving. It is not that you are sacrificing anything, no. That's also another idea. That we have to bear these, nothing of the kind. Look at the life of Christ, he gave his life. Why? What was the need for him to do that? Behind it was the truth. When you have truth with you, the light of the truth, the force of the truth, the strength of the truth, you become emotionally intelligent. You understand that if you really love something, then you have to undergo every kind of trouble. You have to tolerate a lot of nonsense. I know it's too much to say, but I thought that for this special puja, I should say something about the family. In our ashrams, or in our programs, or wherever we are, we should remember this point, that are we having that emotional intelligence when we are trying to talk about Sadhaka. Why do I need to be every place to tell them what is the need? You can tell them. If you have that emotional intelligence, everybody will listen to you. Why not? Not necessarily I should go everywhere and talk to them. In how many countries can I go? And the reaction to it is so beautiful. And so nice, it's very surprising. Like in a country like Benin country, all Muslims there, all black people, they all have become surgeons. 9,000 people. How could I capture that? Just think of that. 9,000 people suddenly become. Then also other countries I've seen, just this is the power of emotional intelligence. That captures the heart of the people. You may have any amount of property, money, everything. People will abhor it. All right. So you may say, what's wrong? What's wrong is this, that you are harming the greatest thing is the human being. As the politicians, they are horrible, as they say. Why? Because they have no emotional intelligence. Also, as administrators, they are very much difficult because they have no emotional intelligence. All these people are devoid of that great quality of emotional intelligence. If your country is very progressive, I must say you must progress in emotional intelligence. That way they are philanthropists, I know. Americans are known to be philanthropists. But behind that is they want to have power. They want to rule people with that money. It's not emotional intelligence, it's they just want to rule. If they start some sort of a charity, that is just to have a big name on the television or to have a very big advertisement about, oh, yes. And then he moves like a tycoon all over. We part of it, they will donate. We part of their property. Work it out and make such a fuss about it because they want to cash it, everything. Cash has been given, so cash everything. You are such a giver. You have to send waves of emotional intelligence. You have to send love to all over the world. You have to show how you can, with love, win over. It is also possible if you are not so attached. If you are attached, say, to your country only. Now, this is a bigger issue. Then you will try to exploit other countries, take advantage of them, try to run them down. But if you are emotionally attached to your country, then you will bring good name to your country by doing real good work. I don't know why people do not know how to discriminate. Why are they so selfish, trying to build them up, trying to do all the good things for themselves? There is a very great chance for all of you to get this within you. You are rich because you are all sajogis. You have become like lotuses. And the lotus has the fragrance which spreads all over. And days together it stays in the water, in that dirty water, and it spreads the fragrance. With that fragrance also you can do lots of things. That the bees come there, they sleep in that beautiful house of a lotus. And in the night it closes down very carefully. All kinds of things that come for the flower to take the little of the beauty of that flower. We can say because you can extract also the essence of that which has fragrance. You can also get some honey out of that. Whatever is possible, everybody comes to that flower. That doesn't mean that flower in any way is weak, but that's his quality, that's his strength, that's his understanding. That's what you are. You are all made into lotuses. You are not made into some sort of creeps or some sort of stupid donkeys. No. You are the people who are to give fragrance of your love, fragrance of your compassion to others. And you should feel happy about it. That doesn't mean that you give up this, give up that, nothing of the kind. But it means that whatever you have, whatever is your possibility, capability, you must try to do for others. Give it to them.